Well, I can't look after you much anymore, that's all.
Yeah, sure. And I bet you'll be real sorry when Bea belts the living daylights out of me, too.
Listen, will you listen to me, damn it? I'm trying to tell you something. I'm trying to tell you that I can't look after you anymore because I'm sick, damn it.
Fletcher!
Congratulations.
You really had to do it, didn't you?
I couldn't lie, if that's what you mean.
Well, I've got to stay in this lousy country for another 6 months because of you. I've lost that recruiting job, and now I've got to try to scrounge a living.
You're lucky you didn't end up in jail.
You've ruined me.
You did it to yourself.
Yeah, well, I hope you rot, you bastard.
Look, I'm not a rich man, but I have enough. You need work. Maybe we could work something out.
Maybe we could. Must have set you back a few, Bob.
My wife was a big spender.
Is she around?
Not anymore. She left me.
Huh. Women.
Sit down. Make yourself at home. Hello, Miss Bowers. Any calls? Pour yourself a drink.
Done.
Ring Ellis back. I'll see him tomorrow. I'm at home if there's anything important. It's not easy running a business with the trouble my wife's causing me.
What's your proposition?
From what I overheard, you're no friend of Fletcher's.
What's it to you?
Do you want to square the account?
Let's start with your interest in my old mate Fletch.
He's having it off with my wife.
Is he now? The filthy beast. Does Mrs. Fletcher know?
I made sure of that. That's why she kicked him out.
Ah, he's been a busy boy, the old Jimbo.
You don't know the half of it. It's not as though my wife were just your ordinary married woman.
They're all the same between the sheets, mate.
You don't understand. She's out on parole. I rang Wentworth. I told them Fletcher was consorting with an ex-prisoner. They just brushed me off.
Of course they would. The whole joint's run by a pack of Sheilas. Fletcher would outfox them any time.
Now, if I can get enough hard evidence to lay before the proper authorities, I can nail him. And that's where you come in.
I'm not a contract cleaner, mate. I don't clean up other people's garbage.
And you're not interested in $2,000.
Why don't you get a detective?
I like my help to be highly motivated.
Do you want your wife back?
Yes.
Then you're going about it all ass up, aren't you? Ringing his wife like that. Christ, that's the sort of thing a Sheila would do. All that did was split his home and push him towards your wife.
He didn't need any pushing.
Look, I know the bastard. Sure, he'd piss off from that bitch of a wife of his. But he wouldn't leave the kids. That's where he's vulnerable, through the boys.
I don't want the kids involved.
You want your wife back, don't you? If you do, you've got to get him back with Leela. Restore the family unit.
Will she want him back?
We've got to make sure she does. And fast.
I'm not giving you a blank check, you know.
I don't accept checks. Just cold, hard cash.
$200 is a retainer. Will that do?
That'll do.
I don't want anyone hurt. No violence.
Sure.
All finished? Yes, all finished.
Yes, well, if I'd stayed in that court any longer, I could have hit somebody. They made Jeff Butler look like the victim.
I'm sorry you had to go through all that, Mick.
Yes, well, I was made to feel a tart. I suppose it's too much to hope that justice triumphed in the end.
He got 6 months.
Is that all?
A suspended sentence.
Oh, what can you do? I mean, he came out of it smelling like a rose, whilst I was made
yes,
to feel
I know. I'm sorry. Really, I am.
So he's at large again. Great.
Don't worry. He won't try anything. He's on probation.
Any normal man wouldn't try anything, but he's paranoid.
Maybe so, but he's not stupid. He wouldn't take the risk. Anyway, I'm first on the list. He told me so outside the court.
Did anyone else hear it?
Like I said, he's not stupid.
Well, aren't you worried?
Well, what's another crackpot threat? In this trade, they go with the job.
Yes, but your friend's a rather special case. What time are you finishing here?
I'm not. I've taken a double shift.
God, you look too tired for that.
Well, I might as well be here as in a hotel room.
Gee, I'm real sorry, B.
Yeah, I know. He asked you to act out an ordinary, everyday incident. Not a full-scale bloody riot. Geez, with friends like you, who needs Vera?
I suppose that means they'll scrap the drama group, do you think?
Yeah, well, they're not going to want an encore, that's for sure.
Does that mean you won't see Ken anymore? Oh, Dor couldn't help it, Bea. She had to defend herself.
Defend herself? Is that what she was doing? Looked like a punch-up to me.
Oh, cheer up. If Ken's really keen, he'll find some other way to get in.
Yeah, they'll always be visiting hours.
Oh, yeah. We can play Tootsies under the table.
I'm real sorry, Bea.
Okay. Forgotten.
Gee, everything always happens at once. First the dog and now this. She was such a cute little thing too.
You don't know that she was put down?
Yeah, Vera could have been telling the truth.
Yeah, believe me, if old Vinegar had had her put down, you'd know all about it.
Yeah, well, I reckon she's dead by now.
Oh. Will you cut it out, Doreen? You've only lost a dog. I've lost a bloke.
Well, I said I was sorry.
Doreen, if you say you're sorry once more, I swear I'll make sure they bury you in 14 different places.
Oh, it can't have been all her fault, B.
I know. It's bloody Sharon. As usual. Oh, boy, that lady's going to be fun to take apart.
And you'll go straight back to isolation.
Maybe I won't mind being on my own.
Staff room.
Meg? Oh, I'm so glad I caught you. It's Leela.
Hello, Leela.
I didn't see anything in the papers about Jeff Butler's trial. I was wondering what happened.
Well, let's say that my opinion of justice has changed somewhat.
He didn't get off.
The magistrate put him on a good behaviour bond. Oh, you should have heard his lawyer. Jeff was a soldier of the Queen, my lads, whose only crime was to get involved with a woman like me. At least that's what it sounded like.
Oh, Mick, that's unbelievable.
If ever I hear about the law protecting the rights of defenceless women, excuse me whilst I laugh. Oh, do you know he threatened Jim right outside the court?
Oh, Meg, would you keep me company tonight? Come for dinner?
Look, if you want protection, you'll need someone with more muscle than I've got to offer.
Oh, it's not that. I need someone to talk to.
Well, I've really got to go home tonight, Leela.
Well, tomorrow night, then.
I just don't want to talk about Jim. Look, I'm sorry, but I work with him, Leela. I'm fond of you both, but I just don't want to be the meat in the sandwich.
Well, we won't talk about Jim then, but please come. After the boys go to bed at night, this house gives me the creeps.
All right then, Leela.
Oh, thanks, Meg. Hello?
Is that Leela?
Who's that? Who is that?
That's a very crisp piece of prose, Miss Bennett.
It's all there, a detailed report.
Yes, and it's very damning.
I agree.
It was a disgraceful exhibition, punching, kicking, biting.
Did B. Smith make any effort to control the prisoners?
Nobody was listening to her, or that man Pierce. If you ask me, putting him in charge was a great mistake.
The drama group was your idea, Mr. Reed. I'd like to hear your thoughts on it now.
My one thought at the moment is to give the whole thing away. Yes, Miss Bennett, I agree with you. Obviously, the women are not ready for that kind of project.
Well, I disagree. I think the drama group is a very good idea. I know they overreacted, but the point is our record on rehabilitation leaves a lot to be desired. Now, if I could have your cooperation in this, I think we should persevere with the drama classes.
Well, I'm sure you have our cooperation. The point is, do we have the women's?
We're only inviting trouble.
We'll see. I shall speak to B. Smith later this morning. Now, is there anything further?
Billy, it's not worth it.
It's worth it to me. G'day, bitch.
B, talk about ungrateful. They're all set to bring the magic of drama and theatre into our lives, and you go and bugger it up. The trouble with you, Gilmour, is you don't know how to act. And you're going to have to be taught.
No one wanted it anyway.
I wouldn't say that.
You wanted it, all right. It was the only way you could get your hands on that smart-ass crim who was running...
Smith, you're wanted in the governor's office. Now!
Why would Mrs. Davidson want to see?
Well, that's easy. To tell me it's no-go with the drama group. As if I didn't know that.
So that's it, Smith. The drama group will continue, and you will do your utmost to make it work.
Well, that's a turn-up. I thought you'd put a stop to
it. I know what you thought, and as usual, you were wrong. So far, you have wrecked every attempt at rehabilitation, but not this time. Now, are you going to cooperate or not?
What? Oh, yeah, of course, whatever you say.
I don't want another shambles like last time. Can you guarantee that?
Absolutely.
Very well, that is all. You will be told when the drama classes resume. In the meantime, I suggest you have a long, hard talk with your thespian friends.
Rhonda will fix it, I betcha.
After what you've told us about her?
Oh, she sounds all right. I'll be, I'm going to phone Rhonda and get her to get our little puppy out of the pound.
Yeah, you do that, Lizzie. OK, ladies, the drama group is back in business. So on with the show.
Don't ring us.
He'll keep. Honey, this time it's not going to be all over the place like a dog's dinner. This time we are going to rehearse properly with scripts. Got it?
Let's do Maid of the Mountains. I can play Gladys Moncrief.
What?
Well, I can sing a bit.
Oh, come off it, Lizzie. I think we'll start with something a bit simpler and head for Hollywood later.
Oh, why don't we write our own play like you did at Christmas?
Oh, yes. Anyone got any ideas?
Yeah. Ken Pierce and the Sleeping Beauty. He fights his way in from the outside. Sword at the ready. But what has happened to the Sleeping Beauty? They've shoved her in the isolation block.
Maybe you won't keep.
Can't you see? That's just what she wants you to do. You hit her now and you blow it. The drama group, everything.
Mrs. Jackson, can I see you?
Well, what is it, Lizzie?
I've got to make a phone call.
Now?
It's a matter of life and death. I've got to make a call to save a life.
Oh, Lizzie.
It's about the pup. I know Miss Bennett put it in the pound. Now, if I can phone Rhonda while she's at work, she can get it out and take it to the halfway house.
I told you, that dog already has a good home.
Oh, you'd just say that anyway.
No, I wouldn't. Now, the dog is perfectly all right.
Well, where's it gone, then?
A member of the staff has taken her in.
Who has?
Never you mind. You get a move on.
Dogs! Dogs!
She's all right. Our puppy's all right.
I suppose you just run over to have a look.
No, one of the screws has got us.
Who?
Mrs. Jackson didn't say.
Oh, she's having us on.
Well, if she is, she's sticking to her story.
Well, why won't she tell us?
Yeah, not fair, is it? That Sharon never does anything without a reason. You've got to get that into your head.
She's rubbed me up the wrong way.
Because she meant to. What do you care? Your bloke's coming back.
Yeah, and everyone's awake up, thanks to Sharon. Listen, do me a favour, will you? Spread the word that I don't really think he's any big deal.
But you've just been telling everybody.
Yes, I know, but if the screws get wind of it, we're never going to get together. They'll see to that. So let's just get this gossip thing under control.
But how are you going to get Sharon under control?
I'll have a word with her.
Oh, Bea?
Old Davo thinks this drama thing is a goer. She's not going to like Sharon proving her wrong.
I don't want to see a doctor.
You'd better see him because I think he'll advise a few tests.
No. Look, I'm okay.
I doubt that. This isn't the first time you've passed out.
Yeah, well, I don't want to see a doctor. And you can't make me, you know that.
The governor can. I'll have to report this to her.
Well, she won't thank you for wasting her time.
Nice to... I'll be back in a minute.
Yes, I was surprised she gave the drama group a second chance.
You were surprised.
Paul Reed must be pleased.
For once, Paul Reed agrees with me. He thinks it's madness giving them another chance to run berserk.
Doesn't sound like Paul.
He's learning. He's not the gullible fool he was when he came here. I told him those women were hopeless, especially Smith.
Oh, well, we all know B. Smith's never going to win a medal for good conduct. But I thought she'd improved a lot lately. And I put it down to the drama group. Gave her the sense of responsibility she needs.
You don't give women like her responsibility.
Lizzie Birdsworth's desperate to know who got the dog.
Well, I hope you didn't tell her.
No. How is she?
Oh, she's turning out to be quite a smart little thing. She's house trained.
Oh, did she like that rubber bone?
Loved it. Well, she knew it wasn't a real one. We really ought to have a yard. I don't like keeping her locked up by herself. It's such a long day for a little thing.
Miss Bennett, is that your little dog?
Yes, it is.
Oh, what a dear little person. You're a friendly little one too, aren't you?
Much too friendly to be a watchdog. Now, if you'll excuse us, we must go for our walk.
Oh, I'm sure she'll enjoy that very much. She's been miserable all day, poor little mite.
Miserable?
She's been crying, my dear. You can hear her right down to the corner. I'm afraid she doesn't like being shut up.
Maybe she'll just get used to that.
Oh, it's asking a bit much, isn't it, little one? I'm sorry to have to be the one to tell you, Miss Bennett, but the body corporate are very, very strict. They won't even allow me to have a cat.
It'll be all right. Oh, it's so nice to have some company. Jim wasn't exactly sparkling, but at least he saved me from talking to myself.
I promised him I'd ask about the boys.
Oh, that's nice of him.
Well, he is really worried about Matthew's asthma.
Well, tell him he needn't. He's been fine since Jim left the house.
Do you really want me to tell him that?
Maddie has improved. I think he's relieved there won't be any more rows.
How's Nick?
Oh, he's too busy getting on with his own life to worry about fractious parents. Tell Jim they're okay.
I know he'd really like to see them.
Oh, well, we can arrange something.
Whatever else Jim's done, he's been a good father. I'll give him that.
No chance of you getting back together again?
I think Madame Caroline would have something to say about that, don't you? No, we're chalk and cheese, Meg. We should never have got together in the first place. We only stayed together because of the kids.
Are you expecting someone?
No. Oh, it's probably some tall, dark stranger. There's nobody there.
Well, that's odd.
Yes. That's the second time that's happened. And there's been odd phone calls, too.
Well, shouldn't you tell the police?
Oh, it's probably kids. I think they expect Jim the Screw to come tearing out after them.
Well, as long as it is only kids and not Jeff Butler.
I can't imagine Jeff Butler coming knocking on the door and then running away.
Really, haven't you got a home to go to?
Could I ask you the same question?
No, nothing much to go home for, so I thought I'd catch up on some work. You doing a double shift?
Yeah, that's right.
That can't be very good for your home life. Couldn't somebody else have done it for you?
It was my choice.
You got problems at home, Jim?
Well, if it's any of your business...
Oh, which of course it isn't.
Lila and I have split up.
I'm sorry to hear that. Is there anything I can do?
No, thanks all the same.
And what brought it on?
Oh, you know, been brewing for some time.
Jim, you know, I took your word for it that you'd be careful now you've left home. And rumor has it that you're having an affair with Karen and Simpson. Now, if you are having an affair with her, just remember that she is out on my surety. I let you go bail for her. Therefore, I could be in trouble.
You've got nothing to worry about, Paul, I promise you.
I hope you're right.
Who's there? Who is it? Jeff?
Day. Hurry up, Birdsworth.
Good morning, Miss Bennett. Isn't it a bonza day?
You're pleased with yourself.
Well, we thought she'd gone to the Knackers. We thought she was lying somewhere with her little paws folded and her little eyes closed. At least now we know she's safe.
How do you know that?
We heard that she'd gone to a good home.
She's got no complaints.
Oh. How much does it cost to feed her, Miss Bennett?
Look, why ask me?
I hope she's not being locked up all day like her old mates.
Look, that dog gets plenty of exercise. The person who has her takes her for walks every night.
That'll keep you fit. I hope she's getting plenty of gravy, Beef.
Look, shut up and mind your own business.
Miss Bennett, you forgot something.
What?
Me.
No.
I'd forgotten how nice you can look.
And I haven't forgotten a thing.
You've forgotten we used to be friends. I mean, may God like us to be friends again.
It's several bruises and a court case too late for that.
Yeah, that lawyer was a real bastard, but I want you to know how sorry I am about that.
You loved every minute of it.
Well, it wouldn't have happened if you hadn't pressed charges. Look, can't we just let bygones be bygones?
Oh, I can't believe this.
Look, if I can forgive you for taking me to court, surely you can forgive me for losing my temper. Meg, I'm trying to say I'm sorry.
Mrs. Davidson!
Meg, who was that?
Jeff Butler.
The man who assaulted you? What's he doing here?
Trying to take up where he left off.
Oh, he must be insane.
He is, but try telling that to the magistrate.
Greg. You do look well. What are you doing back here?
Just couldn't keep away.
Oh, I doubt that.
I'm down for a few days to sign papers. The practice is being sold, and I thought while I was here, I'd put in a few words to Pat O'Connell. Her appeal's next week, isn't it?
That is good of you.
Oh, it's the least I can do.
How's Karen?
She's fine. Fully recovered. The scars worry her more than they should, but I'm working on that. That's her on our wedding day.
Oh.
It's a quiet wedding, just us and Charles and Mary, but it was rather nice.
That's her stepfather?
Yes. He's been very good to both of us. Lent us the deposit on the house. That's a picture of the house. And that's Karen feeding the birds.
Do you mind if I borrow these? The women would love to see them.
I think Karen was rather hoping you would.
Oh, you both look so happy.
Yes, well, we are. I'm working at the local hospital. I get home every night at 6, and then we swim or sit in the garden. Probably be bored stiff with it in 3 months, but at the moment it's bliss.
Looks a long way from Wentworth.
How is the old place?
Oh, reasonably quiet, which means nobody's burnt us down lately.
Have you found a replacement doctor yet?
No one permanent, but Dr. Herbert is still acting as consultant. We have a very interesting medical problem at the moment. A woman who shows all the signs of having a heart condition, but refuses to undergo any tests. I don't see Dr. Herbert coping with her.
Well, would you like me to have a go?
Would you? I'd be so grateful if you could make her see reason.
Looking for something, Lizzie?
Oh, I'm a sick woman. You shouldn't sneak up on me like that.
Oh, give up. Come on, what were you after?
Well, if you want to know, I'm looking for some scraps.
What do you mean, scraps?
You know, scraps of wool and fill. I want to make something, and nobody's got any left except her.
Here you are, you thieving old bugger. Go on.
Oh, gee, thanks, Sharon. That's just what I want. You all right, kid? What's the matter, kid?
It's Judy.
Yeah. I saw her keel over in the garden. But she'll be all right. Nurse'll fix her up.
How do you fix up a wonky heart, Lizzie?
I didn't reckon you'd be upset. Oh, come on, kid. Just because she had a bit of a turn, that doesn't mean she's gonna die.
How do you know she won't, Lizzie?
You take my word for it. She won't die that easy. She's young and strong. Oh, compared with me, she could win the Olympics. Now, me, I got a real crook ticker. Look, you feel that. Feel that pulse.
Hello, Jim.
Who let you in?
The manager.
So much for privacy. Being said, I let anybody in.
I told him I was your wife.
That's terrific.
Well, don't snap at me. I only came because of the boys. Meg said you wanted to see them.
Yeah, I'm sorry. I just finished a double shift. I'm not functioning very well.
You look very tired.
Yeah.
Do you have to do a double shift?
Well, I thought I'd try and earn some more money, but the governor wouldn't buy it. And don't ask me why I need any more. I've got two households to keep now, haven't I?
You could try and be a bit more civil to me, Jim.
I'm sorry. I've got a few problems.
I don't want to bother you, Jim, but I'm a bit worried. There's some very strange things happening at the house. There's door knocking and odd phone calls, window tapping, and nobody's ever there.
It's probably just some kids.
Well, I'd like to think so, but it's too consistent and too late at night.
Well, if you're so worried, why don't you ring the police?
Well, I wanted to see you first.
Hello, darling.
Carolyn Simpson, this is Leela Fletcher. Leela, Carolyn.
Small world.
Yes, it is.
Well, I'd better be off.
Oh, look, please don't let me drive you out.
No, I better go, or Jim will blow a gasket. You will give my problem a bit of thought, won't you? Well, it was nice to meet you.
Thank you.
Jim always did have good taste in women.
What did she mean, women?
She's talking about herself, of course.
I expected someone different.
Look, let's not talk about her, okay?
The last place I thought I'd meet her, did she just drop in?
Well, I didn't invite her here, if that's what you mean. Come here.
No, Jim, I need time to get used to the idea of Leela.
You saw her. She doesn't care what I do.
But I care what I do. I'd better be going. I've got things to do. Besides, you look as if you could do with some sleep.
Look, I don't have to work tonight. Why don't we have dinner together, eh?
You think we should be seen together?
No, I don't. But I don't care.
7 o'clock, then.
Satisfied?
Sir Davidson, could you come back now?
The nurse was right. She ought to be sent into hospital for extensive cardiac tests.
No.
We have to find out how bad your condition really is.
Listen, I let you examine me because I obviously had no choice. But I am not going to hospital.
If you are wise, you will listen to what Dr. Miller says, Judy.
He's not my doctor.
Your own doctor would tell you the same thing. You must have the tests done.
And really, what would that prove? That I've got a heart condition? I know I've got a bad heart. I've learned to live with that.
We can find out if your condition is operable.
Judy.
Judy, are you afraid of surgery?
Huh, of course not. Can't wait to get on the operating table.
Cardiac surgery need be no more dangerous than having your appendix out.
Well, that's a lie to start with.
In the hands of a competent, experienced...
Listen, can you guarantee me that I wouldn't get the same kind of drunken fool my mother got?
The medical profession does police itself.
Oh, really? Then why are there so many doctors still working that it should have been put out to grass a long time ago? How do you tell the eminent Mr. So-and-so that he's passed it? You know, my mother, she had a doctor like that. Top of his field he was for over 40 years. But his ego wouldn't let him put down the scalpel. No, he'd show those young bucks he was still as good as ever. Well, my mother... She died on that operating table. You want to know something? Nobody even said a word.
I'm sorry.
Yeah. So am I. I'm going to go to sleep.
She's going to be a tough nut to crack.
I wonder if Sharon has anything to do with it.
Sharon?
Sharon Gilmour. She's in here. It's a lesbian relationship.
Things are never easy, are they? Do you think this Sharon could talk her into taking the tests?
Depends on the mood she's in.
Well, could I talk to her?
Yes, of course. If you go to reception, an officer will take you there.
G'day.
What are you doing back in Melbourne?
Disrupting everybody's work, that's what.
You're not down here for good.
Oh, I'm certainly not. Listen, why don't you write out a questionnaire and I'll fill it in for you at dinner tonight?
Dinner? Well, like...
If she won't go, put me on the short list.
Oh, I'm sorry, madam. I have strict instructions from Karen to wine and dine this lady only.
I'd love to.
Good. Listen, I've got a dash about this afternoon, so I'll pick you up at home at, 6?
That early?
Well, that way we can eat before we talk. You won't have to cross-examine me with your mouth full. Look, where do I find Sharon Gilmour?
This way to the rock pile. Tell me, how's
it going? Oh, she's fine. Very well.
Yes, well, she should be in the laundry. Feel man enough to face Bee, Lizzie and Doreen?
Oh, good grief, all at once.
Well, I'll go in first and call her out then. Looks as though I won't have to. What are you doing in here, Sharon?
I don't feel well, Mrs. Jackson.
Well, you're in luck. Dr. Miller used to work here.
Well, why didn't you report sick?
I haven't got a temperature or anything. I just feel rotten. I've been worried sick all night about Judy. Has the doctor seen her yet?
Yes, I've just examined her.
She's not going to die, is she?
Well, that could well depend on you, Sharon.
Me? What can I do?
Talk to her. Convince her that it's in her own best interest to take those tests.
But she doesn't like hospitals.
Does she like the thought of dying?
I know Judy. Once she's made up her mind about something, you can't move her with a front-end loader.
There's a 5% chance that she won't survive the operation. She's not willing to take a 5% chance on leaving you alone. On the other hand, if she doesn't get something done about her condition soon, there's a 75% chance that any exertion will kill her.
If those are the odds, she'd better go in for those tests.
You're the only one that can convince her, Sharon.
Yes, who is it?
It's me, Miss Bennett.
What are you doing here?
I'm sorry for the way I carried on the other day about the little dog. I didn't know you was gonna keep her. I'm real sorry.
You're not here just to apologize. What are you up to?
No, I brought a little prezzy. Look, here, I'll show you. It's a little coat for me, mate. I thought what with winter coming on and all that, it is the right size, isn't it?
Well, I should think so. I suppose I should say thanks.
Oh, no need to worry about that, Miss Bennett. I'm just glad she's got a proper place and is going to be taken for walks and given plenty of gravy beef.
Well, you can be rest assured she's being well looked after.
Oh, good. Thanks, Miss Bennett. It's all me own work.
Why chips?
Oh, I thought that'd sort of suit her.
I was going to call her Lady.
Lady? That's bunging it on a bit, isn't it? I mean, for a second-hand dog.
Well, I can decide what to call my own dog.
Of course. But I thought Chip sorts a suitor. Anyway, Chips goes with vinegar.
What are you doing here, Lizzie?
Just on my way, Mrs. Jackson.
Good heavens, what's that? Birdsworth brought it in. It's a dog cover. Chips? Why Chips? Birdsworth's peculiar sense of humour.
Hi!
So this is Melbourne.
Well, it was beautiful until a couple of hours ago.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, okay. Thanks.
Oh, dear.
Oh, do you hire this car?
Yes, it's nice, isn't it?
Very nice.
Okay.
Come on. It's a bit cold.
we put on your coat?
I think we'll put on the other side, don't you? Come on.
Strudel, strudel. Strudel, good dog. Where the devil have you been? She jumped out of the car the other day. The kids were brokenhearted. I hope she hasn't been too much trouble. Oh, good girl. Hey, thanks for finding her. The kids will be wrapped. Thanks again.
Jim Fletcher, please.
That's us as of now. We're so happy it's indecent. Now, give me some news for Karen.
Oh, well, of course, you've heard that Lizzie's back inside.
God, yes. How did she manage that?
Oh, it wasn't easy. No one's ever tried to break out of jail so hard as Lizzie tried to break in. Erica said you were down here to put in a word for Pat O'Connell.
Yes, well, I do what I can for her.
It's terrific.
Now, when are we going to hear some good news about you, Meg?
How do you mean?
Oh, come on, you know what I mean. Everyone needs somebody.
I suppose they do.
Oh, yes, I haven't changed your mind.
No, grilled lobster would be lovely, thanks.
Two lobster, thanks. What were we talking about?
Aren't you going to buy me another drink?
Yes, if I can find the wine waiter.
You went over that way, didn't you? Oh, my God.
What's wrong?
Over there at the bar. It's him.
Who?
Jeff Butler.
Do you want to go?
No, we can't. We've ordered.
Shall I go and ask him to leave?
No, please, Greg, don't annoy him.
Well, we can't let him ruin our dinner.
Greg, I know what I'm talking about. Perhaps it's just coincidence he's here.
Seems to have found company, anyway.
At least I'm not the target for tonight.
Well, I hope no one saw us. I was so nervous I didn't even know what I was eating.
Yeah, well, I don't think that matters. You hardly touched your food.
Got any glasses?
Try the bathroom.
Them. Jim? What's wrong?
Well, it's not right, is it? I wanted our first night together to be something special. Dinner, dancing. Instead, we hide away in the back of some dingy restaurant. And now this.
Look, you know we have to be careful. We've been through all this. Maybe after the trial, and if everything's...
I need you now. More than I've needed anyone before. I don't care who knows it.
I know.
You sure that this is what you want?
Hello? Who is this? Answer me! I want the police.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too, when morning comes around. Last night dreamed we were together, sharing